G'day everybody, welcome to another Affinity Photo tutorial. This week I have a full composite tutorial for you. I call the Assassin. I'm going to start off with this photo here, and you can see I've already used my selection brush tool to make a selection of the sky. I only want the foreground buildings here, so I've just selected those, and I'm going to hit delete just to get rid of all of that background sky. And don't worry too much that we haven't got all the buildings here. We don't need all of them. So I'm going to hit Command D on my keyboard to get rid of the marching ants. The foreground of the city, I'm going to use this photo here. And again, you can see I've used my selection brush tool and I've selected the sky. So I'm going to do the same thing on this picture and just hit delete to get rid of the sky. So it just leaves me with this foreground picture here. Command D to get rid of the marching ants and Command C to copy. Come over to the picture of our background and Command V. We've got our foreground picture in place, and I'm just making sure that I'm on my move tool, and I'm just going to resize that picture to fit the canvas. On the background here, I'm going to unlock the padlock here and just move that up a little bit. But while we're here, let's rename these ones and let's rename this city background. And let's name this one City Foreground. So we've got the names of our two layers here. We're going to add our sky picture next. And for this one, I'm using this sky picture here. And I'm just going to bring the whole lot of this picture over with a Command C. And I'm going to go Command V. And I'm going to move the sky picture right down to the bottom and rename that sky. Let's resize it a little bit, and I'm going to move it up just until I see some of the blue, the lighter blue about here. Not too much that we see the mountains, but just enough that we see some of this lighter blue here as well. So now we've got our sky in place. What I'm going to do is get all my elements in place, and then we're going to add all the little bit of tweaks to make it look a little bit better afterwards. So the next picture I'm going to add is the moon picture. So again, I'm going to use the whole thing, just Command C. Come over to this picture here and above the sky, Command V. Let's change that picture of the moon. Let's rename it moon. And let's change the blend mode on that picture to screen. I'm going to make this a lot smaller now, the whole picture a lot smaller with my Command minus. And while I'm on that moon layer with my move tool, I'm going to stretch that out quite a bit. Move it down and stretch it out a little bit more, and then move my moon in place. And then I'm just going to turn the moon a little bit on an angle. I actually want my moon over a little bit, so we're going to have to make that a little bit bigger. Just stretch that out and move that. Maybe just turn it around a little bit more so we don't have those trees in sitting about there. Okay, after the moon picture, I'm going to add the picture of my bats here. Again, I'm going to go Command C and all the way over and just again in front of the sky, Command V. My bats in, move that a little bit on that side and move that up. So we've got those bats right in the middle there. I'm going to change that to darken. So the blend mode of the bats is being changed to darken. Let's just click on that and name that bats. I'm going to duplicate my bats now with a Command J. And these ones I'm going to come up here to arrange and flip horizontal. I've got a few more bats in place here and just move those down. So the next thing I'm going to bring over is my assassin. And this picture is from DeviantArt, and the link will be below. If you do use the picture, head over to DeviantArt and leave a comment on the artist's site there. That'd be most appreciated. So I'm going to take this picture just with a Command C. Come over to my original picture and Command V. So we're starting to get all our pictures in place. Let's make our assassin a lot bigger because we want him right down here. Just going to make him, he's the centerpiece of the whole picture. So he's going to be quite big right in the foreground here. About where I would want him, sitting about there. So let's call him Assassin. And I'm going to copy that as well with a Command J. Now the bottom one, let's rename that to Assassin Shadow. What we're going to do on this layer now, Assassin Shadow has come up here to Arrange and Flip Vertical, and then Arrange again and Flip Horizontal, making sure that we're on our Move tool. We're going to move that all the way down, place that at the bottom there. I might just move my Assassin back a little bit, Shadow up a little bit. I'm just using my arrow keys now just to get that into a little bit of a better position. So that looks good about there. On that Assassin Shadow layer, I'm going to add a layer effects down here on FX, and I'm going to click on this one here, Color Overlay, making sure that the color is black. Click off that, and then we're still on that shadow layer. I'm going to drop the opacity all the way down to 50% straight away, so we've got our shadow in place. We can start adding some more of our effects. I'm going to start with the city background here, and I'm going to come down here to my adjustments and add a levels. And I'm going to clip this levels to the background, the city background. And on my levels layers here, I'm going to come down here to output white, and I'm going to bring that all the way down to about 3%. You can see it's gone very black. And now I can control that levels just with my opacity slider here. So I'm going to bring that down to about 80% at the moment. We can just see that city in the background there. I'm going to copy that levels adjustment with a Command J, and I'm going to clip it to my city foreground as well. I'm still going to have that at 80% at the moment. I'm going to copy it one more time, Command J, and I'm going to clip it to my Assassin right up on the top here to make him a lot darker as well. I might take the Assassin up to 85 just to make that a little bit darker. So now that I've got my levels adjustment on my Assassin here clipped to my Assassin, I'm going to add some rim light to my Assassin. So staying on the levels adjustment, I'm going to get my brush over here, and I'm going to make my flow 50%. I'm going to make sure I'm painting in black. I'm going to just add some light to the edges of the Assassin. And you can see when I bring my brush close, I don't want to go all the way over here to make it really bright. I want to come right to the edge just so it's going on the edge. I'm going to add that rim light all the way around. I'm going to resize my brush, making it bigger and smaller with my right and left bracket keys as I add the rim light as I go round. I'm going to drop my flow right down to 10% here. Just go over the face. Command 0 to get back, and I've added all of my rim light. You can add more if you like, or a little bit stronger if you like, and we may have to tweak it a little bit later. But then on the top of this Assassin layer now, I'm going to add a fill layer. So I'm going to come up here to Layers and New Fill Layer. Up here to the colors, I'm going to click on the color, and I'm going to come right here to the blues and make this very dark blue down here, almost dark blue, black like night. Click off that. I'm going to change the fill layer to soft light. I'm going to drop the opacity all the way down to about 40% at this stage. You can drop it a little bit more if you want, and if you have to tweak the background or the city background, you can do that on the levels layers here just with your opacity. So you can bring your opacity up or down, make those a little bit brighter. I'm going to leave it at 80. I like the way it looks. And the next thing I'm going to do is behind my Assassin, I'm going to add a bit of a glow. I'm going to click on the Assassin shadow here, then click up here on layer and new fill layer, and that will put that fill layer behind the Assassin. I'm going to change the color to a really glowy sort of, not quite white, not quite blue, so that looks good about there. And on this fill layer, I'm going to add a mask down here on my masks. And that mask that I've just added to that fill layer, I'm going to invert it with a Command I. Now we can't see it. Again, on my brush, I'm going to click B on my keyboard to get my brush. My flow is good at 10%. I'm going to make my brush quite big. and make sure we've got our colors back to default by hitting D on our keyboard. And I want to paint in white this time, so I'm going to hit X on my keyboard to paint in white on that inverted mask. Now I'm just going to add my glow right behind my assassin here. Got our glow going, and I'm going to drop the opacity on that fill layer with the mask straight away down to 50%. Have a look at that. That's not too bad. So the last few things I'm going to do, right on top, I'm going to come down here to my live filters, and I'm going to add some clarity. You might have to just click on your clarity and drag it up so it's just on a layer by itself. And on this box here, I'm going to take this up to about 20. So just add that little bit of clarity in there. And I'm also going to add a little bit of noise. I'm going to do the same on my live filters. Come down here to add noise. And again, you might just have to click on that and drag it independently up just so it's on its own, right up the top here. It's not clipped to anything. And I'm just going to add about 5% noise. So 5% noise there. And very last thing, right on top again, adjustment layers. Let's add our curves layer so it sits right on top. Let's bring the middle down here. Let's darken that up a little bit. Just create a little bit of an S curve. And there we go. So that is my picture this week of the assassin using the 6 different photos and blending them all together. You can send this picture over to tone mapping if you want to add a little bit more detail. So you just have to click on the curves layer, hold your shift key down and click on the sky layer at the bottom. Come over here to layer and merge visible. Make one layer with all of these layers inside. Once you've got all of those layers merged, you can come up here to your tone mapping here and click on detail here. You will want to bring your tone compression down all the way down to about 3%, and you'll want to drop your exposure a little bit just to make that a little bit darker. And that adds a lot more detail into that picture. The other thing you can do if you want to make it black and white, you can come down here to the high contrast black and white, click on that. Again, you'd want to bring your tone compression down to about 3%, and you can play with your exposure a little bit darker, a little bit lighter. I'm going to just click cancel here at the moment and just leave it the way I originally had it. So there you go, everybody. If you have enjoyed the tutorial, don't forget to leave a like. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit that notification bell so you know when my next tutorial is coming out. If you have really enjoyed the tutorial this week and you would like to support my channel, you can head over to the Buy Me a Coffee site. That will be linked below. But until next time, I'm going to say to you, stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in my next video.